Welcome to Going Deeper on Bivvy.TV. Today we're going to look at polarised glasses. They're an item of tackle that, or piece of tackle that I just wouldn't go fishing without. It doesn't matter if it's a grey day or a bright sunny day. Locating fish is so important, and polarised glasses definitely help us do that. Wiley X is a company that's brought out some glasses specifically for fishing. Frank knows a little bit about them, so Frank, perhaps you could tell us some more.
Yeah, well, Wiley X are quite an established company in the shooting world and skiing and other sports like that. They can take a shotgun blast. Wow. If you look at YouTube, there's a film showing them shooting from about 12 yards away with a shotgun with a 6-gauge shot, and it never penetrated the lens on the glasses. So the military have bought them because they found that in Afghanistan and in Iraq previously, when an IED went off, there was troops losing their eyes just wearing normal sunglasses. So there was shots, the Wiley X have got shots of blokes that have lost their face and their eyes have gone. They've got shots of guys that are wearing these where they kept their eyes but the face was still badly damaged, but your eyes are, you know, so important. And I thought, well, where does that apply to fishing, really? And then I thought back to instantly an incident that happened with me. It was about 12 years ago. I was fish spotting. I climbed up quite a big birch tree. And it was a well-established climbing tree where you could look down on the top lake at Cape Slanall in Cheshire. And I got a pair of optics on, Cormorants. Good glasses, great for looking in the water, everything. And I was close to the tree trunk and I just turned my head and there was a nail that someone had used to, as a handle to climb. Yep. And it stuck in the lens, poked the lens out, the lens fell into the lake and the nail scratched my eyeball. I went to the Manchester Eye Hospital to get treated by it, but I nearly lost my eye. So you suddenly think, well, it was so easy that it will never happen to me. There's several anglers lost eyes, but if they'd been wearing these, they'd still have an eye. So you think, right, okay, do I want to go the whole nine yards and buy something that's this sort of strength, or do you just stick to what you normally use? So I guess it's down to the individual what you would want, you know.
But a decent set of Polaroids, you know, a good pair cost a few quid.
Yeah.
And I mean, if they'll put up with that, then they'll put up with people sitting on them and
that's
all
right,
the normal
yeah.
things that sunglasses end up going, you know, rattling around in your tackle bag or in the car. So, you know, they're not going to break under normal conditions, and hey, if they put up with a shotgun shot, well, all the better.
Well, I've been sat here really quietly, and I'm just waiting for someone to shoot me.
Well, we're going to do that in a minute, Steve, demonstration.
All right, I know there's something at the end of it.
We did it earlier, and one of the pellets bounced off his nose, folks. You might be able to see the injury there.
Yeah, very good.
So I saw the colour of the lens on this pair here. I mean, they're quite bright on the front, but brown is certainly the colour of the lens that I would choose for fishing.
Yeah, well,
it certainly works for me.
Exactly. I mean, they reckon that a lot of the bass fishermen in America, the top pros that fish for money, use these.
Yep.
A lot of the guys that fish for marlin and everything else, and I suppose they look slightly poserish, I guess, in some respects, but you can wear them to go out and do your thing, as well as use them for fishing.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, that mirrored effect definitely helps cut down glare. I worked on big game boats for a very long time, and you know, the better glasses definitely had that on the front, whether you like that look or not.
They do so many different ones in the range.
Right,
they're not all this colour. There's some that are just like the normal brown colour and like amber colour.
Yep.
So
which is great in low light conditions.
Yeah,
isn't
absolutely.
It?
Yeah. So you've got a huge choice amongst them, and I quite like them. I think they're really quite nice.
Well, it looks like we'll be seeing a few more of these. We're going to give them a test, see how really robust they are. I think we might even get Steve casting at them to see if they'll put up with a test like that. No scratch on those.
It's hit it right on the lens. Come across it.
That's a lead, a zip lead, almost point blank range. And he's dinted the point on the lead. It's not gone through the lens. It's remarkable, really. At almost point blank range.
That
straight in the lens, it's bounced off the lens. Amazing. So that's two massive blows, high impact, and that was a 2.5 ounce zip lead, and it's just ricocheted off the lens. So there's no doubt in the strength of those old boys. Remarkable. And that's at point blank, so if you were pulling lead that was stuck in the ground, in mud or in a tree, and you did have an accident, it'd save your eye every time. So, that's what price you put on this pair of eyes, I guess, isn't it?
Right, I'm going to shoot it, SAS style.
Well, there you go. The glasses are put up with quite a lot of abuse from the boys, and they've withstood it really quite well. So, yeah, they're as tough as they claim, Frank.
Yeah, they are, definitely, because I hit it at point blank range with a catapult twice. Shot it with several shots from this thing.
It's called an air pistol.
Walther pistol, yeah.
There you go.
And
so they should be able to put up with most things that an average or everyday carp angler can put up with. And so, yeah. Good pair of glasses, well worth having a go with.
Definitely.